We have actually come across the notion of frames earlier. When we were talking about production systems, you may recall we had a diagram like this, where we had procedural, semantic, and episodic knowledge, and a working memory container structure like this. You can see this is really a frame. Here are the slots. Here are the values for the slots. We can think of these frames as capturing conceptual knowledge that is stored in the semantic memory. So let's take an example. Suppose that the input is Ashok ate a frog. Remember the word ate there. And that verb ate gets written in the working memory. And the entire frame for it gets pulled out. Once this frame is pulled out of semantic memory, it immediately generates expectations. So we now know that ate is likely to have a subject, an object, and a location, perhaps time utensils, and so on. So we can ask ourselves the question, well, what will go under subject here? What will go under object here? And in this sentence, Ashok ate a frog, this frame tells us what to look for. As a result of which, the processing is not just bottom-up, coming from natural language or the world in general and going into mind. Also, mind provides knowledge structures like frames, rich, structured knowledge representations, which generate expectations and make the processing partially top-down.